Hey folks, I want to do something a little bit different with today's video. Instead of looking at the weather that's to come, I want to have a little look at the weather that took place in the past. Now, for the last few weeks, I've been plugging in my videos, the website where I get these excellent charts from that I use for my videos. It's wetterzentral.d, that's wetterzentrale.de. Now, not only do they have all of the major computer models, all of the charts from all of the major computer models, they also have an extensive archive of historic charts. And today, I want to use some of those historic charts to look at a particular weather event that took place in January 1940. Now, for the last few days, we've been hearing quite a bit about freezing rain. There was quite a nasty freezing rain event that took place across northern England the other day. Well, it was nothing compared to what happened in 1940, because then we really did see a very exceptional and severe freezing rain event. Now, this first chart what I want to start with is from the 9th of January 1940, and this really just puts the month into context, because it was a severely cold January. The central England temperature for January 1940 was -1.4. Now, for the past few decades, we'd actually gone through a bit of a warming trend across many parts of the country. There haven't been many severe cold winters at all. There'd been one in 1917, and there'd been a pretty cold winter in 1929. But basically, the first three or four decades of the 20th century were quite warm, and there are very few severe winters. So when this January came along, it really was a bolt out of the blue, and it was actually the coldest January since 1895, and it did end up as the second coldest January of the 20th century. Now, it didn't start off too badly, but by the 9th of January, we were starting to see what was beginning to take place, and we were starting to see this area of high pressure building over Scandinavia. That is very often how our cold months begin, either with a blocking feature over Scandinavia or with a blocking feature over Greenland. All of the coldest months really will contain one or both of those features. So January 1940, the severe spell in that month started off with high pressure building over Scandinavia and pulling the winds in from the east. As we went on into the month, we found that that high pressure actually built over towards Greenland, and it built a very large blocking feature over much of the North Pole. At the same time, a very severe cold pool developed across much of central, northern and eastern Europe, and you can see that that high pressure over the pole and over Greenland did start to move that severely cold air our way. So look at this upper cold pool that we had across the continent on the 17th of January 1940. These are the 850 temperatures, and we had 850s down to -40 in the west of Russia and heading in towards Finland. That really is exceptionally cold, and that extreme cold air did come our way through the middle part of the month. So that really puts the month into context. It was a very cold month, a very blocked month, with easterly and northerly winds. As we went into the latter part of the month, the blocking feature did begin to relent somewhat. You can see that over the North Pole, the heights have lowered quite a bit, but we still have high pressure on the 26th of January over Scandinavia. And with what happened is that we had a big area of low pressure, a big trough in the Atlantic, starting to push our way. Now, this is a classic battleground situation. So we have weather fronts coming up from the west and from the southwest, and we had high pressure over Scandinavia, and we had a legacy, of course, of very cold air and probably a lot of snow cover across the country. Now, as we went into the 27th of January, this is really where the ice storm started, because we have the weather front starting to move up from the southwest. We can see this here with the kink in the isobars, and those weather fronts were meeting that very cold air that was already established and was trying to be fed in by the blocking feature over Scandinavia. And if you have a look at the upper air temperatures, this really tells the story of what happened, because remember, I've said in videos over the last few days that with these continental situations, snow can fall anywhere but in the green colours here. So these are 850 temperatures. Anywhere that's in the green can see snow falling. But once you get into the yellow colours, then it's much more likely to be rain. That's because the air aloft is too warm to allow that snow to fall down to the surface, so the snow falls out of the cloud and it falls into rain. But once we get into the north, we do have much more in the way of snow. And that's what happened in 1940. We had that area of weather, that area of rain coming up from the southwest. It had got quite warm upper air temperatures with it, but freezing cold surface temperatures. And so as the rain fell, it did produce a lot of ice as it froze onto those surfaces. Now, temperatures on the surface across much of southern and southwest England and Wales were down as low as -2 to -4 Celsius. So as that rain fell onto those surfaces, it did cause some very severe disruption with ice. And it wasn't just that was the problem, but the real problem with this is that it went on for so long. So as we go into the 28th of January, we still have the battle taking place. We've got high pressure to the east, we've got the low pressure to the west, we have a weather front lying across these western, southern, southwestern parts and up into northern England. And neither of these air masses were willing to give way, so it just went on and on really for several days. So as we look at the upper air temperatures on the 28th of January, well, it's very similar. Perhaps the green has pushed back a little bit further to the west, so perhaps the cold air is winning the battle slightly to the north and the east, so we would have seen a lot of snow. In fact, we did see a lot of snow across northern England and down into eastern England. There was as much as 20 inches of snow in some places, and drifts up to 4 feet across northern England. So yes, there was a lot of snow from this in the north, but the yellow colours here, we've got them still going, the upper air temperatures, warm upper air temperatures through much of western and southern Britain. And yes, that ice storm just went on for another day. And as we go into the 29th, well, it's very similar really. The high pressure perhaps is building a little bit more over Scandinavia, but the low pressure still isn't giving ground, and we still have that weather front there across central and southern and western parts of the country. So looking at the upper air temperatures, well, still it goes on for western and southwestern parts of the country. The ice storm did continue. This is the third day, can you believe, of continuous heavy rain, and yes, freezing rain, sheet ice, glaze across all surfaces. As you can imagine, it was absolutely terrible, the conditions, with the power lines being brought down, and you couldn't get around because the ice was so thick, walking was impossible, there was no chance of being able to drive anywhere, and the ice just piled on top of ice. Now once we get to the east and to the north, yes, we have the risk of snow, and we probably by the 29th of January were seeing the snow easing off across northern England and parts of eastern England as that cold air was slowly winning the battle. And it wasn't really until we got until the 30th that finally the high pressure won the battle. It established the easterly wind and the weather front was pushed away to the west and to the south, although even then we still probably got, we'll probably have freezing rain going on down across the far southwest. So this really was an exceptional spell of freezing rain, severe freezing rain across many southern and western parts of the country. It was extremely disruptive, one of the most severest weather events of the 20th century, in a particularly cold month, of course. And I thought it was interesting to take a look at this because, as I say, we've heard a lot about freezing rain over the last few days, but it was nothing compared to the event, the very significant and severe and disruptive event that took place across much of southern and western England and Wales in January 1940. Now, if you've enjoyed this video and you'd like me to do some more looking back at past events that have taken place, I can go all the way back to 1871 with these charts, but obviously once you get that far back, there's not as much detail around these events. But certainly for the 20th century, I can look back at some of these events. If you'd like me to do more videos like this, then do please use the comment box to suggest perhaps what years you would like me to look at. And over the coming weeks and months, I'll be more than happy to do that. So I hope you've enjoyed this little look back at this severe ice storm of January 1940. That's it for now.